Now, Wellington is facing a raft of problems at the moment, a decaying infrastructure and rampant inner-city crime. But the council can't be blamed for this latest issue.
No, believe it or not, a Chinese rocket is now hurtling back to Earth at nearly 30 kilometres an hour, and one of the places it could be in the firing line is none other than our nation's capital. Space correspondent Julian Lee reports.
Chang'an Wuhao B, or Long March No. 5B, launching from the Wenchang spacecraft launch site, a display of the might of the glorious and much-loved Government of the People's Republic of China. The Chinese government has proclaimed it a great success. Except they left a tiny bit out. Namely, a big chunk of the rocket itself is now hurtling back to the Earth. The biggest piece of space junk to hit the Earth in over 40 years. In its path, many possible options. Wellington has been mentioned.
Here on Wellington's Lambton Quay, the public seem to remain blissfully unaware that just above them, an out-of-control Chinese government rocket is hurtling at over 28,000 kilometres per hour. Fortunately, if you remain vigilant and taking the necessary precautions, being kind and keeping their distance.
But it's not all bad. According to some, parts of Wellington are just crying out for a rocket, a way to fast-track a much-needed city renewal.
And Josh Kirkley, an astronomy educator for Stardome, joins us. Now, great to talk to you, Josh. Should Wellingtonians be wearing helmets and staying indoors? I mean, what should we be doing to prepare?
Kia ora. No, not just yet. It's not as big of an issue as a lot of the headlines would lead you to believe. But yeah, no helmets or hard hats just yet, basically.
All right, so let's talk us through it. Has this ever happened before, Josh?
Yeah, I mean, things falling back to Earth is not uncommon itself. Rocket boosters are a pretty common thing to be falling to Earth. You know, we've had really large things, like some of the old space stations from the 70s and even into the 2000s. Those are really large objects that have re-entered Earth's atmosphere. But having something this big hasn't happened for quite a while. You know, this Chinese rocket is about 30 metres long and 20 tonnes, so it's a really sizable object. So we haven't had something this sizable for several decades.
OK, so speaking of sizable, how can we predict where it is going to land?
Yeah, well, it's kind of difficult. We can't really know exactly when it's going to fall until it's basically almost about to fall, so we can track it for the coming days and weeks. We believe that it's probably going to fall either this weekend or probably early next week, but we're not going to know exactly when or where until it's probably quite close to doing it.
Josh, how does something like this happen?
Well, this was actually a mistake. So what typically happens with a rocket launch is a rocket is sending something into space, usually as it's using fuel, the first stage, which is usually the bigger part, that typically drops away and falls back to the ocean in like a controlled re-entry. In this case, as it was launching the Chinese part of the space station, it actually got too much velocity, too much speed. It ended up putting itself into orbit just like the station. So it was actually totally accidental. It shouldn't have been up there in the first place, unfortunately.
Thanks, Josh. Fingers crossed we don't get hit.
Yeah, no hard hats just yet. You're all good.